When we discuss electrochemical cells, we could draw pictures as we've done in previous videos. However, it is easier to use a notation format to symbolically describe electrochemical cells. In order to do this, the oxidation half-reaction is always on the left of the notation, and the reduction half-reaction is always on the right side of the notation. A double vertical line is used to represent a salt bridge that separates the two half-cells. A single vertical line indicates substances in different phases in the same half-cell, and the single vertical line represents the boundary between the two different phases. If there are multiple components in the same phase in the same half-cell, they're separated by commas. Finally, if you have inert electrodes, they are also included in the electrochemical cell notation. In this problem, we're asked to write the cell notation for each electrochemical cell illustrated below. In the first example, we see that we have a zinc 2+ half cell, and on the other side, we have a copper 2+ copper half cell. This is the electrochemical cell we've been working with previously. We recall that the oxidation half cell is on the left, and so we would write zinc solid, and then a single vertical line, and then the zinc 2+ aqueous ions. The zinc solid, zinc 2+, represents the oxidation half cell. We then indicate the salt bridge with a double vertical line. We then write the reduction half cell, or the cathode half cell, so that we have copper 2+ aqueous, and then a single vertical line, and then the copper metal. In the second example, we have a copper metal, copper 2+ half cell, and we have an iron 3+, iron 2+ half cell that has an inert platinum electrode. The oxidation half cell is copper metal going to copper 2+. The reduction half cell is iron 3+ going to iron 2+. So we would write this cell notation as copper solid separated by a single vertical line with a copper 2+ in the aqueous phase. We then represent the salt bridge with a double vertical line. And in the reduction half cell, we have iron 3+ aqueous separated by a comma with iron 2+ aqueous. The phase boundary with the inert platinum electrode is a single vertical line, and then we write the platinum solid. By now, you should be able to describe the rules for writing electrochemical cell notations. You should be able to write cell notations from drawings of voltaic cells, and you should also be able to write cell notations from equations of redox reactions.